Thwala.
Action.
Action is who? Woo! Hey! Okay, Christmas is on Tuesday. And of course, the crazies are coming out. I see how everybody has decided to live half their mind with Christmas. Like, I'm so over it. I'm so over it. Even people who are supposed to be working, you come up to them and you're like giving them a job or work. And they're like, neto, manyeno Christmas. Everyone is blaming everything on Christmas. You go down to the bus park, hey, it's Christmas, twayongeza. You take a taxi, it's Christmas, twayongeza. And we buza na mafuta mu Christmas ibagongeza. Like it's too much, but hey. It is still the spirit of giving and cheer and love and all those beautiful sugar, sweet and spice nothing things that come with Christmas. My name is Tina Fierce One, and before we can do anything, it's a Friday. Let's get it. Because today we're taking a minute to do the Kampala sign and we're going to be running through it because let's just say the week has not had that much gossip. Christmas, all our artists are not even performing. Have you seen our artists performing at different places? I don't know. People. Anyway, the Kampala Sun is coming to you. In case you don't know what time it is, get yourself a copy of your weekly daily dose of gossip. Now, in gossip here in Kampala Sun, they're saying Akena's ghost haunts Kanyamunyu's girlfriend. Now, if all of you remember the Kanyamunyu story, guess what? It's still going on. I was even shocked. I thought it into Bachi Maridiza. How? Anyway, they're calling them back to court on the 21st of January. Now, what killed me, though, is Kanyamunyu's girlfriend. What was her name? Zoba Charito, Zoba Happiness. One of them. Comfort Charito. We don't really care because she's anyway, the girlfriend says she's okay with coming back to court, but she's only going to be able to testify if whoever is conducting that particular trial can do it in flawless, fluent French. Jesus. And that I was like, wait, that is a twist. That is a twist. Why would she want it to be done in French? Do you think she feels like if they use too much ingress, she will get lost and probably, I don't know, say the truth? I know she's Francophone, but anyway, that is what is coming out from that world. And of course, everyone has been waiting on this story. We can't wait for justice to be exerted because last time I checked, Kanyamunyu was out on bail. His girlfriend was, well, somewhere, but also on bail or something. Man, the stories that rock this nation. I don't, in their celebrity death match, I can't believe that Kampala Sun can take it like this. This is below that belt. How do you pit a daughter against her father? How? So in their celebrity death match, it is Sheila Gashumba versus her dad. The story that actually did bring me, that made me want to really read the Kampala Sun today is their biggest headline. Serwada is a son of the devil. That is according to Pastor Aloysius Bujingo. Now, I know most people don't like talking about the men of God. We have had this thing going on for way too much. And for me, for way too long. For me, I'm always like, no, I'm not attacking a man of God if I am speaking my peace and my opinion. Now, I know most of you out there are wondering what started this. Now, of course, Serwada called, Bujingo called Serwada, Illuminati, and then Serwada called Bujingo a mandazi seller. I was like, couldn't they even come? Don't you think they're like, do you think the Bible has good shade? Like they could use Bible verses to throw shade at each other, but hey, they're petty like this. Now, this whole thing escalated. The fact that the government came out and said, yo, check this out, y'all is too many out here, we're finna register you. Serwada, being apparently but I highly doubt. But Serwada is head of pastors. Now, according to Bujingo, because Serwada was for it, Serwada is like, yes, but registering, let's get this issue out of the way. Bujingo is like, no. As they're still doing that, then someone again threw in, all pastors and religious clerics or leaders should take up theology. Now, the Catholics were seated in the corner like, Mugenda na mwe musome kumrekila kutomeze ndigaza mwe. Now, a local on the other hand are like, Neda, the calling is the calling. You do not need an education to get that calling. Jesus just anoints you, or God anoints you, and then you can perform all these miracles. If you honestly do ask me, though, I am team, let's register these churches. Let's. There are too many people. When you walk down the street in Kampala, in between every four bars is six churches. I don't even know how that equation and mathematics adds up for us. And what scares me the most is the fact that all these different churches all have their own entities, and they all have their own rules, regulations, what you should abide by, what you should... It's like having a tiny little government. Have you ever thought about that? That churches are like a tiny little democracy in their own tiny little government. Because you have to respond to what the pastor says. You have to bring what the pastor says. Do what the pastor says. If the pastor declares 65 days of no eating or drinking, that is what you'll do. Because, I mean, he's the man of God. He's anointed. And in this particular process, because of all of that happening, things have gone haywire. We shall never forget what happened with the Chibwetere cult. That was something so sick that it was so sick that I never expected us in the year and age of 2018. Now, I do understand millennials and life being a little bit messed up the way it is. People have decided to look for something that is a little bit more trustworthy, and we're all headed back. We're going to either two things. We either go back to Jesus or we hit the bottle. One of the two. Now, it's half and half. Those hitting the bottle were many, and those going to church. Now, the numbers that are going to church are the numbers that we are trying to have protected for a minute. If you tell me register them, I'll say what you have to lose. I'm not even going to go I'm not going to go religious like that. I'm just saying, man, these are all pastors that have had. I've honestly had the chance to listen to Sewada preach. I have for years, and he's beautiful at it. I've also had the chance to listen to Wujingo preach. Yes, he's pretty much like the gossip king of there. He reminds me of that local girl from Kabusu. You know those local girls? Mizigo je Kabusu. Naenga wachiriko nebwacho ogera. And I think, given these two work together for a minute, where did that disconnect come from? Like mutulekemu, if the pastors are fighting, what should the congregation do? The congregation but for how long? When will you get your answers prayed? Rather, your prayers answered when the pastors are still having a tweet or a Facebook fight handoff. I can't stand all this stupidity. I can't stand this pertinence. I can't stand it, but the part that I don't really stand is the fact that I don't understand it. That's a sad bit. Oh, well. How I see it is not how you see it. But even as that is happening, banange mweddeko bagenda baba sente mugendo collecting ebimu ebyekumi mugendo okuzimbira ba pastor ba mama yumba mubagulira amamoto kamuba wasize na abakazi mugendo bikola byonna. Which is not a problem because you're looking after the anointed of the Lord. But make sure as you're doing that, it's all for the right purposes. I'm just saying, okay, wait, what's the right purpose for helping your pastor get married? So that you can get a pastress. This year has been good for Slay Kings though. Slay Kings have ruled this year. The girls have not done much. I have... Instagram has been awash with all of these Slay Kings. I mean, the Aspers were dominated by the male. The male people are the ones we wanted to actually see more than the females, because the females, it's sad, but I have to be honest, we have seen your boobs, your butts, your legs, your inner thighs, inside your toes, in your teeth, in your hair, out your hair. Off your hair. I mean, we have seen it all, and there is still nothing much to see. So we are done with Slay Queens. Let us look at all these Slay Kings. Rock, but the Slay Kings are also very disappointing. I mean, Babi, Bafere, at most of you, they are sitting on fences. I have learned one thing that has pissed me off in Kampala, and it is wrong, wrong, wrong. Half of the Slay Kings in Kampala sit on fences. One minute they are Slay Kings, the next minute they are something else. The only reason that they want to be that something else is because they expect to get money to fund their Slay Queen. Mbogere. Mbogere. Temwe mani. Eriku street, mbogere ako bilala. Oyo guy. Abali muno. We are going to start naming and shaming. I'm just saying. I want to take this grand opportunity. Okutumirako, njagala tumira abantu abalina sente na yenga bekubenja ula. Chitegeda. Period. Ngenda tankane number one man. Balaam.
banaye balamu sabavulu balamu kusente zolina tata nchimanyi watulangira da like about 2 weeks ago balamu came out and told us move kusati yange balamu rocks that same orange shirt I don't know he must have like a house full of that orange shirt I don't know bo musawo ya mugamba eddagala liri mukano tata bwabanga yagambe eddagala liri mwako mbadde nsaba Odayo omugambe tulijja mukano tuliteke wachiriko mu t-shirt ya black choka sigenda kusaba binji kuba bwe nakusaba mbo chuse ngwe twejja chisobola nkwega irite si papa Muloza si papa, na yuko senteza si papa zalina. Si papa has more cars than clothes. And even when he has the clothes, it's the time I bumped into si papa at a radio station, I almost threw up, eh? Because I didn't know, I just saw like a short dark-skinned thing pass by me and I'm like, bambi, you know, chia kaze kuna onya ID ya bula. You know those things at radio stations, they're like, nanga ID yange, nanga munti yange ya bula. They're like, no. Oyo yes si papa ngayamba debi sapatu ebi tracker suti ebi t-shirt akakofira I was looking at this guy I'm like why would I have all your money and look Jesus of course someone is going to tell me Tina not everybody is materialistic I don't want them to get materialistic I am simply stating bambi mutu yambe muchuse Ronald Mayinja sente zokoledde ku bantu abana Uganda banayi Ronald Mayinja koze sente simanya Ronald misachi bawaluka gabo bani bakoze sente mpya ne nkadde mu bana Uganda mu nyimba zaabwe ezo olola beko Ronald Mayinja nga bayambala ayambala ngempewe zikunta ayambala nga anatera okutuka enkya bamuseeyo Ronald sente zizo wachi we kubenja ulo That's been my time. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle and on Facebook it's at Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Like, follow the pages on Instagram. It's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I can't wait to see you on Monday. It's going to be Christmas Eve. And yes, I told you I do have something for you. For now though, don't forget, don't drink and drive. Get you a designated driver. Always wear protection. Always wear protection. Other than that, I'm out. Peace.